Appendix 8, Famous Ada Cases. Bragdon v. Abbott, 1998. The Supreme Court found that, even when HIV has not progressed to AIDS, it still constitutes a disability, as the virus significantly impairs the life activity of reproduction. Pennsylvania Department of Corrections v. Yeske, 1998. The court ruled that state prisons must comply with Title II of the ADA, as they are public entities. Wright v. Universal Maritime Service Corporation, 1998. The Supreme Court ruled that a general arbitration clause in a collective bargaining agreement does not require an employee to use the arbitration procedure for an alleged ADA violation. Albertsons, Incorporated v. Kirkenberg, 1999. The Supreme Court held that circumstances mitigating the determination of disability include not only devices and medications, but also an individual's ability to compensate for their impairment. Cleveland v. Policy Management Systems, 1999. The Supreme Court ruled that pursuing and/or receiving Social Security disability insurance benefits does not automatically prevent an individual from pursuing an ADA claim, nor do such SSDI benefits presume against the recipient's ADA success. Murphy v. United Parcel Service, 1999. The court found that a UPS worker's high blood pressure did not significantly limit his life activities when the worker was medicated, and that he was, therefore, not disabled. Olmstead v. LC, 1999. The Supreme Court ruled that to stop or to avoid discriminatory activity, the state may place people with disabilities in community settings rather than in institutions. When the state's treatment professionals find the placement appropriate, the affected person is not against the shift from an institutional to a community setting, and the placement can be reasonably accommodated. Sutton v. United Airlines, 1999. The Supreme Court found that determination of disability must include measures that might mitigate a disability, such as, in this case, eyeglasses for those with visual impairments. EOC v. Waffle House, Incorporated, 2002. The court ruled that a private arbitration agreement between an individual and that individual's employer does not prevent the EEOC from filing a court action in its own name and recovering monetary damages for the individual. Lane v. Tennessee, 2004. The court ruled that courthouses must adhere to Title II of the Americans with Disabilities Act, which guarantees access to public facilities and services, and that individuals may sue states for failing to provide access to courts. Spector v. Norwegian Cruise Line, 2004. The Supreme Court ruled that foreign-run and owned cruise ships serving U.S. ports must comply with the public accommodations requirements of the American with Disabilities Act. ADA case information on the web. Olmstead Resource Center, www.lre.org/resources-olmstead-implementation. U.S. Supreme Court homepage, www.supremacourt.gov.